Yeah, Canva does it again. Canva has given us whiteboards. And let me show you what it is that I'm about to use whiteboards for, because it is about to be a lifesaver when it comes to my businesses.
She's an icon, she's a legend, and she is the moment. Now come on now.
What's up, icons? It's the iconic fashion figure, and Canva has now introduced Canva whiteboards, and I've been playing around with it to see what I can do with it. And as I'm going through a lot of their templates, I can see there's a lot I can do with Canva whiteboards. But one of the ways that I really believe is going to be beneficial is with my marketing calendar. And how the marketing calendar works is I have a list of tasks, they're on sticky notes, and they have their deadlines. And for each task, there is a process to get it completed. So as we go through the process, such as creating the graphic designer can go in, and once their portion of the process is completed, they will move the sticky note over to graphics completed. And then you would do that for each task that's on a sticky note. Now, once the graphics are done, then the next person can go in and create the email notifications or push notifications too, and then move it over. Then the next person can go in and they can schedule whatever needs to be scheduled for that task. And once they've completed the scheduling, they will then move that sticky note over to schedule. So that way we know for the entire process where each task is to be sure we meet that deadline. And once it's sent out, it's completed, and we can move it over to completed. And that would be it for the entire process. Now, for the past year and a half or so, I've been using Excel, or what's on my computer is Numbers for Apple, for my marketing calendar, which has worked, and it's worked really well. It's more old school, but sometimes there's no need to fix what isn't already broken. So I've just stuck with Numbers. I mean, I've tried different things. I've shown previous videos where I've tried something else in Canva as far as like a social media calendar. I've tried different apps on my phone. I've tried, you know, like Trello and all that stuff. I've tried a bunch of different things. Excel or Numbers, as I use, is what has been like tried and true for me. That has always worked. It's kept me organized, but it's not aesthetically pleasing. There's no pictures. I do very minimal color on there. I guess I can color it up and make it a little more visual, but I'm gonna use Canva whiteboards now because that's actually worked. So I want to show you guys how I'm actually using Canva whiteboards. Now, on the whiteboard, I'm gonna go through and set it up because I'm starting with a blank slate. I did choose one of Canva's templates that they give us as an option, but I'm going to alter this a bit to make it my own. I started out by adding all the different headers and titles and adding in all the dates. I also added in additional rows because I need a row for every day of the month. I probably should have started out by doing all of my colors first, so that way when I got to the point of adding the additional rows, the colors would have just repeated. I didn't have to go change them in the end. You'll see what I'm talking about once I get to the color portion. I probably should have done that first. But when I did this, I started out by adding in all the titles, dates, and headers, putting all the text on there that I needed on the calendar. And then next, I went in and I changed all the different colors of each of the cells to make this easier on the eye, especially since I'm going to be looking at this calendar every single day to make sure I'm meeting deadlines. I want this to be something a little more exciting to look at every day and not so boring where I feel like I just have to work and I don't feel like doing it. So I'm not going to bore you guys by sitting here watching me change the colors of these cells, because I switched this around a couple different times until I got colors that I actually liked together and in the order that I like. And once I got done playing around with the different colors, this is what I ended up with so far. Not done yet, but this is where I'm at so far. Next, I'm going to work on sticky notes. And each one of my brands is going to have its own sticky note, and each sticky note is color coordinated based off of the brand. That way, myself or anyone that's looking at this calendar, once you see the color on a deadline, you know which brand you're working on. So you know that brand has something due for that date that needs to be done. So I have Iconic Fashion Figure, Nouveau Rich Apparel, Fashion Formula 101, and now Mr. Rich. Each one of them will get their own color. Basically, on this left side of my calendar is going to be like the key to let people know, or let the team know, I should say, because no one else will be accessing this, but let the team know, you know, what color represents what. I know what color represents what, but they may not remember until they get used to working with this. So I'll make sure to color coordinate it and include a key so they know. Now, those connectors, I don't need those, so I deleted them out. Those would be good for those of you that may be creating more like a map instead of a calendar, and you need to connect sticky notes together because it might make sense for your notes on your calendar. So you can keep the connectors if you need them. I deleted them out just because I don't need those. The text at the top I haven't updated yet, but basically I'm gonna go in there and put in directions so each team member knows what it is that they're supposed to be doing when they enter into this calendar. And then the shapes I'll be getting into in a moment. So now over to the right section of my marketing calendar. This is the what needs to be done section. So this is like the reminders for everyone that's working on here for all the actions that needs to be taken for the task. Now, not every task is going to take every action, but each task, once I show you guys the planning portion, you'll see that I'll list under there the actions that need to be taken. So this is just the reminder of what those actions are. And once I list out the actions like the emails, the push notifications, the pop-up box, etc., next to it, I'll put in descriptions of what each one is so that each team member knows what it is they need to do when they get to this step and they see those actions that need to be taken for each task. But now I'm gonna make the actual sticky pads that hold the sticky notes that I'll pull to create, you know, my tasks for the calendar. So what I'll do is each brand will have its own sticky pad, and I'll create the template on here and everything in a moment. But when I go to create a task, when I'm actually working on my calendar, all I do is duplicate the sticky pad for that brand. And on each sticky pad, I'm going to put the task that needs to be done for that brand, and underneath it will be all of the different actions that need to be taken. Now, sometimes I'll have a link too that I need to add, but that's usually on an as needed basis. So I won't put it on the template, but I will add the links when needed. Finally, into the planning portion. So this is where I go in and actually start adding the task onto the sticky notes along with the actions. Now, this is something I usually will start doing like a week or two before that next month. So I would do it in the previous month for the following month. I've done a video previously on how I come up with the ideas for my marketing. So I'll link that video in the description box if you have no idea what type of task to even create. I mean, you're gonna see some of the tasks that I'm gonna create in this video, but I did a full thorough video on how I come up with the different ideas for my marketing. So now that the first task is complete, this is what I will use to move along in the process. So once the graphics are done, we'll move it to the next column, and then we'll start working on the actions. Once the actions are completed, or at least created, we move it to the next column, and then I have to go in and schedule those. So once those are scheduled, it moves on to scheduled, and then once they actually post or publish, then it will be moved to completed. Now the full process is done for that task. So on planning day, I always start out with everything in the queue. The queue is basically, you know, the brainstorming phase, just trying to figure out what it is that I want to do. So everything goes in the queue on planning day. Those sticky notes were all over the calendar already because that was from the template. So I'm moving those. But in order to add additional sticky notes onto the calendar, all you do is go to the sticky pad and duplicate the sticky pad for the brand you need one for. And then that's when you can add in another task onto the calendar. So I'm gonna go through and create additional tasks on here so you guys can see what it would look like to have multiple tasks on the calendar. And then I'll come back to you guys to show you so you don't have to sit here and watch me create a bunch of different sticky notes. So once all my tasks are created, this is what it would look like in the queue. I put some tasks onto the calendar so that way you guys can just get an idea of what the calendar would look like once you start filling it up. I'm not gonna continue going on with September because technically September is almost done and I should be working on October. I just wanted to show you guys what I had so far, or at least the tasks that I've already done for the month of September. And then this is how it would work. You would just keep moving the different tasks along the calendar as they're done. Let's say at some point we decide there's a task we don't want. Just throw it in the cancel pile because we're no longer going to use that one. One more thing I want to show you guys for the marketing calendar, and that's if you want to use this for social media marketing as well to schedule like your social media posts. So let's say this picture right here, I know I want to post on Instagram. So I want to start scheduling out, or at least planning out what I'm going to post on Instagram or TikTok every month. So this picture right here, let's say I want to post it on September 5th, which was Labor Day, I believe. So when I'm planning it out, I'll put in the queue. But once the picture is edited, then I will go ahead and put it under graphics created. Now, as far as the email notifications section, there's really not much actions to this, so I can skip it and go to scheduled, or for those of you that take the time to create, you know, captions and hashtags, that can be your actions for your social media posts, or you can just skip that column altogether. And you can do the same thing for your TikToks and Reels. And then those, you can just use the cover of the video and and put it under the category. So most likely is already going to be edited if I have the cover. So I'll go ahead and put that directly under graphics created. And this is helping me to know what day I'm actually going to post it on. So this will also help to spice up your marketing calendar with some images so it looks aesthetically appealing. Plus you're scheduling out, or at least planning out, your social media posts at the same time. And to take it a step further, those shapes that I haven't used yet, you can use those to represent the different social media platforms. So each platform would be represented by a shape. And then as you're doing your planning, you would just change the shape to the color of the brand for that post. So for example, on September 10th, I know that this cover that's on here will be posted to TikTok for Nouveau Riche, because the color behind it is for Nouveau Riche, the shape is for TikTok. You can do the same thing for the September 5th post, which is supposed to be for Instagram. We can go ahead and add in the circle, which represents Instagram, and then put that behind the actual image that's being posted. So that way I know on September 5th, this picture should be getting posted for Nouveau Riche apparel. You can also pre-plan out your captions and your hashtags. So every item that's on the whiteboard, you can add in comments. So if you click on this little icon here where it says add comments, you can go ahead and type in your hashtags or your captions for that image. So that way it's already done before you even get to the point of scheduling the post. And then when it's time to actually go schedule it, all you have to do is go in and copy what you've already added into the comments and paste that into your caption or your hashtags. Now I'm just giving you guys a general idea of how to use Canva whiteboards for a marketing calendar. It can be for project management. It can be for numerous of things to keep up with, you know, your daily tasks, your productivity, product management, you know, a lot of different ways you can use this. I'm always looking for ways to stay organized because that's what keeps me on track. That's my reminder of making sure all my tasks are getting done. Without these calendars, I have no idea. You know, I tend to get lost because I'm doing too many things at once. As you guys can see, I have 4 different brands that I'm on here trying to market. And then I need to be able to collaborate this information with teams. So I want to make sure that I have an efficient way that we can all keep up with what we have going on. Now, what I've shown you guys today is what you can do in the free version of Canva. Of course, you can upgrade to Pro, which I'll put a link down in the description box where you can upgrade to Pro, and you can do a whole lot more. You have a lot more available to you in Canva, but this is just the basics, which is getting the job done. And I know you guys tend to like the free templates I usually give you of the crazy things that I usually come up with in Canva, so I'll make sure to leave a link in the description box as well so you can download the template that I've already created, and then you can adjust it to make it your own. Now, when you guys download the templates, I highly recommend already having a Canva account if you don't already, because when you go to download that template, it automatically imports into Canva. Now, usually if you're not signed into an account already and you go to download the template, it'll make you sign in, but Canva won't actually import. You then have to go back and try to download it again after signing in or creating an account. So make sure you're already in your Canva account and then download. I think that's it for this video. I'm gonna play around with Canva whiteboard some more and try some other things because I see some other things that I can do in here, especially like there was one template I saw on here that kind of worked almost like a tech pack, but for a different project where you can show step by step on how something is done. It's really good to show like a presentation, but a quick one, to other individuals or your team if you need to. But that's something I'll have to show in another video once I actually play around with it and see if it actually works with what I have in mind. So I'll show you guys that at another time. Thank you for watching.